Fans, we're back on Saturday night, and as we head towards Starrcade, I talked last week about the great career of the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. He has been really synonymous with the main event, with the world title match at this prestigious event.
And I'm shedding a tear, Tony, because it's all going to come to an end. The 27th Starrcade, last we'll ever see of the Nature Boy. You better hold on to this film you're going to throw to.
Let's take a look at Ric Flair, the past, the present, and the future of this great athlete.
1993 marks a decade for wrestling's first big event, Starrcade. During the previous 10 Starrcades, one wrestler has by far been the center of attention, the Nature Boy, Ric Flair. It was on this very first Starrcade, aptly named A Flair for the Gold, that Ric Flair became the world champion for a second time.
Now back to the corner. You got him cornered, and he's going to fight his way out.
Flair,
the referee's still down
right
on his
hand.
Knees, and the referee in trouble right now. Here's Flair up on the top rope.
One, he's got him down. One, two, three. He did it. He did it. Ric Flair has done it. No question about it. Ric Flair has just defeated 7 times world heavyweight champion Harley Race.
8 world titles would follow, and the career of Flair would grow stronger and more famous with every one. During his career, the Nature Boy has become more than a champion in the ring. He has become one of its top celebrities. He is a man of style. Style in the ring, exemplified by the figure four leg lock and his awesome backhand chop. And style out of the ring with his flamboyant lifestyle. In 1991, he left World Championship Wrestling and headed north for the World Wrestling Federation. The dominance continued. In his 2 years of competition there, he twice won the WWF Heavyweight title. Of all of the big matches, the one that lies ahead is the most important in this storied career. Vader, the 10th anniversary of Starrcade, and a chance to be the world champion for an 11th time. More than that, Flair has put his entire career on the line for this one shot at once again wearing the gold. Athletes and coaches from all over see this challenge as one that Flair can rise to.
If there's anything here that I can compare this to, it would be Michael Jordan and the Chicago Bulls. You ask, why would Rick, at this point in his career, this time of his life, put it all on the line this way? Certain things make special people champions. There's something that separates them. Michael Jordan won the scoring championship in the NBA for 7 straight years. If he came back one more year, it was inevitable that he would break the record and would win it 8 straight. But Michael Jordan also went out and won 3 world championships. Michael Jordan constantly was motivated by little things that he set out in front of himself as the next challenge. Could he make a foul shot during a game with his eyes closed? He did it. Was the game on the line? No. He knew when to plant the seeds, when to self-motivate to get himself to the next level. Perhaps at this point in Rick's career, he needed something, the ultimate challenge, to make him reach a new level, to overcome Vader. In my mind, there's no question, Rick will do it. Now, I may be a little bit partial to a smaller person in this case.
He's ultimately putting his career on the line, and there's a lot of concern from his friends such as me and other people, because this guy's a freight train. I've seen this big guy move around the ring, wrestle. He's 400 some odd pounds, and you know, we're all concerned. And hey, Rick's on top of the wrestling world. We don't know why he wants to do this, but he's the ultimate competitor, and I kind of have a feel for what he wants to do, because I'm a professional athlete myself. But we're extremely concerned, and you know, I'd kind of like to see him do some other things and keep his wrestling career going and stay away from people like that, because he's a smaller guy. But you know, you just can't measure Ric Flair's heart, and he's a hero of mine. He's right up there with Richard Petty and all those people in my mind, and I'm a big Ric Flair fan. I wish him the best.
On December 27th, another chapter will be written in the career of the man known as possibly the greatest wrestler in this sport. All eyes are going to be on his hometown of Charlotte, North Carolina, as Ric Flair walks that aisle one more time to capture the gold. He is a man of the prime of his career, risking it all. Facing Vader is one monumental task. The question is, can Ric Flair do it one more time?
Rick, I'm the man. You the man. Vader, you ain't ready to be the man, because you ain't beat the man. You big, but that just means you're going to fall longer and harder. Because Rick been the man as long as I can remember. We've been friends a long time, and a lot of people are doubting him, but I never doubt him. He's beat a lot of bigger, a lot better than you. When you ready to beat the man, it won't be Rick, because you don't have a chance.